Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, continuing our exploration of the Crescent Nebula. We are leaving Zaline. One of the planets in here had some Eclipse Merc activity. Found out something about a missing ship or something like that. Well, this is kind of on the way. Let's fuel up while we're here. Keep going. Lusarn. Ooh, Ezo-rich planet. So excited. And you know what? We have stuff to do. We have an upgrade. Oh, didn't we do that already? No. We need an upgrade. Yeah, I want what's her name's power. Miranda. Can I quit out and just check that out?
No messages for you, Commander.
Good. Armory. I think we can get any of these, nope. Advanced training. Nice. Biotic body slammed and inflicts massive damage. And then we got stasis. I want slam. This is from Miranda's loyalty mission. Nice. Okay.
No messages for you, Commander.
I'm not sure if I have to review that or if I just get, put points into it or whatever I do when it's time to like head out into a world. Squad. You know what? Yeah, I can get into squad at any time, true. Okay, so we got this slam. I have 0 points to do though. Burns through armor, sets enemies on fire, and damages health. Nice. So eventually, if we keep doing this. Crippling slam improves brief slam incapacitation, or heavy slam greatly increases slam force after lifting target. I think I'll choose that one eventually. Alright, so let's check out the system. Number one planet is a gas giant, apparently. Jontan is a fairly standard close-orbiting Pegasid gas giant orbiting the star Lusarn at high velocity and heated to temperatures of over 1,000 degrees. Analysis of its orbit has revealed a core of heavy elements with a mass double that of the planet's hydrogen-helium atmosphere. Okay. So out of this, yeah, we need some platinum.
Launched.
Game gets impatient. Okay. All I want now is Ezo, actually. We have over 100,000 and everything. So. And there is no Ezo. Untanta. Yuntanta is remarkably close to Earth. Its orbital distance is similar, and while slightly larger, its reduced density yields similar mass, atmospheric pressure, and gravity. There, the similarities end, for Lusarn is a hot class F star, emitting over 8 times the energy of Sol. Yuntanta is a parched wasteland, its water long since boiled away into its nitrogen carbon dioxide atmosphere. A handful of mining outposts dot the hellishly hot surface. The crews remain in underground bunkers, sending remotely controlled machines out at night to do surface work and load cargo for shipment. Population is 230. Scanning. Just looking for Ezo. None. All right. Third planet. Dorie. If I'm saying it right. Dorie is a large, hot world with a poisonous atmosphere of acidic nitrogen oxides. While the planet is too close to Lusarn for this to condense and fall as rain, this makes the environment too hostile for forms of life more sophisticated than bacteria to evolve. We have good here. But we don't need any of this stuff. There's the Ezo-rich planet, Tarith.
I have detected an anomaly.
Oh, and an anomaly. Tarith is broadly Earth-like with a fatal flaw. It has a relatively high amount of chlorine in its atmosphere, the reason for the greenish haze that becomes apparent when looking at the horizon. Chlorine has become a vital component in Tarith's plant life as a defense mechanism against native herbivores. Many species evolve the ability to release clouds of toxic chlorine when disturbed. Great. This gas is heavier than the atmospheric oxygen and tends to settle in low places. While avoidable, this has placed Tarith near the bottom of the list for colonization. There are intermittent signals originating in the heart of a large chlorine swamp. They appear to be coded, though it is not impossible that they are garbled distress signals for a downed civilian ship. Alright. Trying to home in on this.
We're just waiting on the weapons at this point. They'll never know what hit them. The Vorture are hungry for battle. We're just waiting on the weapons at this point.
Vorture are hungry for battle.
Something on our sensors.
Preliminary scans indicate a high-powered communications relay on the planet. Communications match known blood pact mercenary protocols. A concentration of Krogan and Vorcha signals are massed inside what appears to be a mining operation. Life signs detected. Unknown species. Advise caution. Not landing just yet. Gotta check out this Ezo. Yo, hoo. Over here. Nice.
Launching probe.
Just a little bit more. Come on, give me more. That's nice. That's nice. Oh yeah. Right there.
Probe launched.
And some palladium as a bonus. You can now avoid the advanced training. Okay, so we can do more of that when we want to. Hey, hey.
Probe away.
Even just a little bit is worth it.
Launching probe.
Three at once. When it comes to Ezo, I double, triple check. Here we go.
Launching probe.
I don't think I've ever gone down that low.
Probe.
Nice. Almost 9,000 now. Oh, there's more. So exciting.
Probe away.
Okay. Yeah, you wouldn't kid. Ezo rich planet. Nice. Quite happy now. Yay. We'll land here in a second. Also check out this last planet. Looks pretty. Oh, I like that. Zedek. A common methane ammonia gas giant, Zedek is best known for the infamous Kalthor camp. Established on the ice moon of Gasis, Kalthor was a Blue Sun's hostile environment training facility run by a cadre of former Batarian Special Intervention Unit operators. In 2168, a cluster-wide scandal broke out when it was revealed that the mortality rate of recruits sent to the camp might be as high as 18%. Investigation by authorities based on Ilium uncovered group graves around the facility containing the remains of several hundred recruits, dating back two decades. The camp was immediately closed and the remains sent back to their worlds of origin. An inquest by the Blue Suns found the Batarian commandos had used harsh training methods, but these were consistent with their own training to join the SIU. The Batarians were exonerated, though Kalthor was shut down and they were reassigned to other units. As the Crescent Nebula is beyond the sphere of Council law, no civil charges could be filed against the Blue Suns. Scanning. Just looking just in case of Ezo. I thought I saw a little bit. It was iridium, I guess. You know, you'd think this game could detect that you've already sent, like, hundreds of probes, and to stop telling you how to send a probe. All it needs to do is count a variable every time you send a probe, and it would know that, yeah, you know how to do it by now. Alright. Don't need anything there. Let's go land on Tarith and disable the blood pack relay. Alright. Who shall I bring this time? I try to give everyone equal time except for Miranda because I don't like her very much. Mr. Morden? And Grunt, I suppose. Okay, can't give him any points here. Cryoblast? Or incinerate? Let's take... Advanced plasma round melts or burns nearly anything it hits, or incineration blast. Splash zone in this plasma round is increased, allowing you to scorch multiple targets. Let's take that. And we can take a cryoblast. We got 1 point. What is this? Neural shock. Interesting. Something to look forward to. Their weapons should be fine. Ooh. Okay, it's a centipede dragon mosquito thing.
The fog on the planet's surface is interfering with your navigation. The nearby beacon towers may serve as a navigational contingency.
Really? Sounds like froggies. So, plants can attack us with this, like, gas that hangs near the ground.
What happened here? Problematic.
Think so? Attention all workers. Stop chipping away at this node. There's nothing left here to mine. Move on to the other sides now. Salamul. Salamul? Cool. There's a damn beacon. I see it. Very obscure aliens reference.
Toxin concentrations exceeding safe levels. Proceeding with caution.
Okay. Saving. When's it gonna start affecting us? Oh, little thingies.
Time to fight!
Oh! It's a Klixon. It's an exploding Klixon. Beacon. So I guess we just follow the beacon. Obviously. What's that? Oh. More Klixons. That missed.
Yeah, right under your ass.
Oh, there's another. Okay. Continuing. It's so foggy, that's the bad thing. We can't get a good look at these clicks and things. Going this way? More material? Okay. 400 platinum. Well, don't get stuck on stuff. Oh, that's scary looking. Now I got a good look at it. Where are you guys? Okay. Where's Morden? Alright. We can see better around here. Is this where we came from?
Why were they here?
Oh no, this is a new area. Hold that round.
Signs of recent fighting.
Attention all workers. Fall back now. Evacuation shuttles are on the way. Anyone not at the gathering site when the shuttles arrive will be left here with those damn bugs. Salamur. Wherefore art thou, Salamur? It's really strange sounds here. Well, so far this mist doesn't seem to be really damaging us. It's leaving, I think. For now. Raw material. Another 400 platinum. Are you like hiding and stuff, Morden? Because I never see you. Holding out on me here.
Hostiles!
I'm in the air, though. Oh, brother. Oh, there's a lot of those things. Come join me up here. I'm hoping I'll just reset. God damn it. I'm through the beacon. Oh, you're up here too. How you doing? What's up? I'd love to go back down. There's Morden. Oh, damn. Stay on the ground.
Up front!
Oh, I got the slam thing. Oh, it's a biotic body slam. I don't want to body slam this thing.
Just nothing to help.
Saving, because I got stuck on stuff again. Salamur. I can't get any more Vorcha from Omega. Garm has his own problems. You're going to have to man up and deal with this on your own. Maybe build a beacon path. I bet those damn Vorcha are just wandering off into the fog and getting lost. Kalusk. I like these names. Salamul, Kalusk. Oh. Raw material? That's around the other way, I forgot, because I reloaded. Let's go back and get it. You guys, yeah, slacking off back there. Let's save and run back. Save again. Mostly because we keep getting stuck on stuff. Well, we did once, and I don't want it to happen again. The raw material seems to be off on the side, so we'll get that first. Another 400 platinum. We are full of rounds. This way. Beacon. I haven't found any baddies for a while. Beasties. Beastie baddies.
For combat.
Yes, we are.
Just the thing to help.
Stop it!
I shot it, not you. He ran away. A data pad. Salamule, where are the resources? Are you mining out there or standing around waiting for those Vorcha to get smarter? Our guy on Ilium can't keep the lights off forever. You keep stalling and we'll have a hell of a fight on the way in. And that would make me really, really angry. Kalusk. Wonder who that is. What's this way? Does this just lead in a big circle? Beacon. What's this way? Did we come this way? Oh! Blood pack!
Enjoy.
I should run here. Guys, all right? All right. Refined platinum, 400. Now I'm getting lost out here. Oh. There you guys are. Is this where we came from? I think so. Maybe, maybe not. It is. Alright. Yep. Objective is this way. Down that way. This is where I was heading before I decided to go back. Yeah. Really, really angry. Oh, this is a dead end. What way then? This way? Doesn't look familiar, so. Supposed to go this way? What? Came from this way. Am I headed back again? I think I am. Let me just make sure. Yeah, this is familiar. Sorry, guys. I'm not sure which beacon I'm supposed to be following. That's where we fought the Vorcha, right? Oh, we can go. Oh, never mind. I didn't notice that ramp. Okay. What an eerie place, wow. What is that sound?
Not afraid of you.
You sound like black metal. Oh! Uh-oh. That's Selimule. No. I'm gonna die. Unity. Run. Oh, I'm stuck. Wait, I can back up. I can't go forward, but I can back up.
I'll put them down!
I don't know what it is about ground like this. You can't... I can move now. Is that it? Sorry guys, I couldn't move. Let's save. Any more data pads to look at? Communication terminal? Bypass time. do we find? What's going on? Are we able to communicate? Oh, that's it. Okay. Encountered unclassified hostile alien species, eliminated blood pack forces. Give me a guess. 125 experience? Yes. 7,500 credits, 600 platinum. Done. Alright. Any messages, Kelly?
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Thank you. As opposed to my public terminal. From Cerberus Command, Planet Information, Zataban Zaychas System, Shrike Abyssal. We have decrypted and analyzed the data you recovered from the relay on Tarith. Oh, good. The resources mined on Tarith are being sent to Zataban, presumably for use in weapons manufacture. It's clear that the Blood Pack is planning a large-scale invasion. Disrupting the operation on Zataban will go a long way toward delaying or preventing this invasion. Okay. I will endeavor to do stuff like that soon. Okay, so next episode, we will check out, I think there's one remaining Undeste. Just get some fuel and stuff before I forget. Okay, thanks for watching. Next episode, we'll check out Undeste and see what there is to be found there, and then we'll be done with this nebula. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.